You know, I want to salute our medical professionals. We owe them a great debt of gratitude. And in one particular instance, 40 years ago, the life expectancy of a child born with Down syndrome was about 20 years. Today, that life expectancy of that same child is 60 years. The 400,000 Americans with Down syndrome are living richer, fuller lives. The sad news is that new prenatal testing puts unborn babies with Downs in more danger than ever. As one Surgeon General said, it's a amniocentesis is a search and destroy mission. Well, Laurie Johnson has more on that entire story. Here's Laurie.
Until now, pregnant women who wanted to know if they carried a baby with Down syndrome had to wait about 17 weeks and risk a miscarriage to learn the answer. Today, there's a faster, safer way to find out. All it takes is a simple blood test as early as 9 weeks into the pregnancy. Unfortunately, that leads to far more decisions about whether to abort.
Down syndrome is a genetic condition in which a person has an extra chromosome and as a result has some physical and mental disabilities. For every 10 expectant mothers who are told their baby has Down syndrome, 8 choose to abort that child.
Denise Bassett was about to be one of them.
I had trusted in God, and I believe in God, and I counted on Him for everything, but I was starting to think, well, what if he had made a mistake? And maybe I needed to do something about that.
She had signed the abortion papers. Then, at the last minute, Bassett called a pregnancy crisis hotline and spoke with Cherry Jensen.
Medicine is not an exact science, which we all know, and no one can predict the potential of a child.
As it turns out, Cherry's daughter has Down syndrome. At age 33, Jenny has accomplished much more than doctors said she ever would.
Do you feel God using you?
I do. I do believe that God's using me for so many ways.
Jenny says God uses her to spread love to many people. As a hospital volunteer, she's a vital link between the patient and the healthcare staff.
The patients love her. She's kind, she's caring. We never have to ask her to do something twice. She never forgets a thing.
Jenny also takes care of kids at the YMCA. Her boss says she's like a ray of sunshine to the children, their parents, and her coworkers.
I know Jenny personally, and a lot of times we sit in my office and talk about faith in Christ, and it comes right from that. She is just a big-hearted Christian. She loves the Lord, and it's evident on how she lives her life.
And it was Jenny who helped stop Denise Bassett's abortion. Jenny's mother, Cherry, convinced Denise to postpone her decision until she met Jenny.
When Jenny prayed over the food, I'd realized the love that she has for God. And then when in our conversation she was talking, she had just touched my arm. And I really believed it was God speaking through her to me, telling me not to be afraid and trust in Him again.
And with that, Denise decided not to abort her child.
God gives life. It's not your decision to take it.
I'm so big. Yay.
Months later, Denise had her baby, a little girl named Abby, and is so glad she did.
My daughter is beautiful. She was born with no heart problems, no kidney problems, no leukemia. She's more advanced than what I ever thought she would be.
Denise says God has opened all kinds of doors to provide for her and Abby. And as you can imagine, two of their dearest friends are Cherry and Jenny, who help pave the way. Laurie Johnson, CBN News.